Okay, so you may be wondering why you're here today. I know you guys, I've worked with you guys the most here in my internship, which is to complete the final semester of my fall. Okay, can we start over again?
Nope, no, we're good, thank you.
Okay, fine. Thanks, Jennifer. You're right, I'm being ridiculous, I'm just having a conversation. So, anyway, so I started the internship.
You have been doing a fantastic job. We really appreciate you coming in and helping us out.
I know.
Public speaking is the number one fear over all fears. It's even greater than the fear of death. So people would rather die than publicly speak.
Oh, no. I concur, and it's... I'm being ridiculous.
No. Feelings aren't ridiculous. Feelings are feelings. And you can try saying they're ridiculous, if that helps, but it usually doesn't. It just makes you feel worse. So feelings are just what happens.
Okay. All right, so you guys know why we're here. I'm doing an in-service for my library internship to complete my MLS. And part of that is explaining a technology-based resource that is used to help the college achieve a goal. There are two parts of the in-service as defined by my instructor. The first is this presentation, which is going swimmingly.
Yes.
And the second is the actual product or the project working towards the goal. So I was initially going to do the in-service on the intranet, but as I was researching, the intranet is very intricate, and I decided that the scope of that was going to be far, far too large for a little 15-20 minute talk.
Okay, sounds good.
So I decided to focus in on the archives project that you are allowing me to spearhead, which I very much appreciate. And the first part of that was choosing a host site for the archives project. To do that, basically just consisted of research to see which site would support the campus's needs the best.
In other words, free.
Yes. Yeah, I think, let me see, what were the actual requirements? It needed to be free. And it had to be able to embed in libguides.
Correct.
And I think there was one more, video and text maybe, or images and text.
Has to be able to do images and text so that we can have a more kind of pleasant look to it. Because everybody likes, your eye is drawn to pictures first, and then
Correct.
We want to be able to put the text in for conveying information. Then the other requirement is we had previously tried to have a timeline, but the service that created it went out
right, that's
business.
It. You had to be able to download it. I couldn't remember that third one.
And that's the part that's been a problem for me, is just trying to find something that would work with, and I just haven't had the time for it. So I was hoping that with you being in school and working with and trying out these different resources, you'd be able to help us find something that would meet that.
Mission accomplished. Welcome to Sutori. I decided to use Sutori mostly because the other sites that I found were either they didn't meet the basic criteria, so either they cost money or you couldn't embed, were the general problems. Most of them allowed you to save off-site. I think there was one. My favorite, Timeline, wouldn't let you save off-site. I know, it was so easy. I liked that layout too. But Sutori was a really good option. The other difficulties were mostly aesthetic in nature, and that's why I didn't choose those. They either had too wide a margin, or you couldn't set your own dates, essentially, was the problem. And they were either too wide apart or too narrowly focused, and it would just look weird with what we were trying to do. which I didn't explain for those of you who don't work at Wake Tech. Essentially, we're attempting to create a timeline of the programs at Wake Tech. When did each of the programs start? And if possible, we wanted to include an image, maybe a newspaper clipping or some sort of something to break up the text and to grab people's attention. So that is the reason I was searching for a host site in the first place. After I chose Sue Torrey and began actually looking through the archives, I can see the time. Lisa,
she told me to.
Time. I can see. Anyway, so Sue Torrey.
Mm-hmm. So we did meet all of our requirements.
Yes, but. Once I started looking through the actual archives, I realized that because I'm going to be working with a partner, the other intern who's searching for her MLS as well, and we don't work at the same time, so we were going to have a system to record the information so that we didn't get confused. So I created this very high-tech logging system, which you probably can't see, but it's just columns with the date, the title article, the degree that is being introduced, and where the photo or image is of the article, so we don't have to keep searching through in case somebody's looking through the articles and somebody's uploading to the site. It would really streamline this as a collaboration.
And I do want to go ahead and say that I was able to introduce it to Sony, and she was able to figure out, she's like, this is fantastic. So this is
okay.
Exactly the information that was needed so that we could keep this going.
Okay, good. I'm glad to hear that. In that line, I also created an instruction guide, which is very simplistic, but would really help, especially because Sue Torrey wasn't involved in choosing the site that we were going to use. So I really wanted to make sure everything looked the same, that everything was formatted the same, so that it had a consistent feel throughout the project, so that it doesn't look like 12 people are working on it, even though that may end up being the case.
Exactly.
So the instructions are very simple. All you have to do is sign in to Sue Torrey, which I've already done to save time, and sign into LibGuides, which is where we're going to embed the software. I'm not actually going to go through embedding the software into LibGuides. I'm just going to explain how it would be done in the essence of saving time as we are pressed. It's almost closing and we have 5 minutes. So,
LibGuides has a box that you select. When you click on that box, you can say add content widget. The important thing is having a code that you can put into the widget.
Exactly, which you copy off of the Sue Torrey site, which I will actually show you where that is. And sorry, Jennifer, I know this is going to be very much a repeat for you.
No, this is good.
Okay. I do apologize. An assignment requirement. So once you're on Sue Torrey, the timeline site, I'm going to scroll through the ones that I've done so far to the bottom. Once you're ready to add an entry, you simply click. And because we chose the free option, the only ones that you're really going to be able to choose from that will remain in the project after the 30-day trial are text, image, and did you know?
I'm so happy with the did you know.
I know you are. I did those just for you. Anyway, so in order to add a new date, you simply click text, type in the month and the year, and that is because that's sort of how it was broken down in the papers, and we had more than one a year, and I wanted to get more specific than that. So we'll just say July of 2000, which is obviously not true, but I decided to bold and underline the headings. And after you've done that, you simply go and you choose image. And then you choose the image that matches the date that you just created. And I am not going going to choose an image that actually is a date. I'm just going to choose a random koala bear.
Sounds good.
Yeah. And then you simply see your koala bear and add a description. After you are satisfied with your project and you're ready to link it to the WaitTech site, once the project is completed in its entirety, the way that you'll do that through this site is simply go to Share, Social Embed, and you'll copy the embed code and put it straight into LibGuides. I know you're so happy.
I am so happy with that.
Yeah, straight into LibGuides, and I've tested this. This does work. But again, in the essence of time, we're not going to be able to get into that today. Okay, do either of you have any questions?
All right, so with the koala bear testing is what we put in there. With the actual project, that would be where you put the title of the department or program
we
that started. Yeah.
We can see here, you would put the newspaper image. Yeah, the newspaper image. I've not been taking very much time with the captioning right now.
Mm-hmm.
I figure I'll go back and kind of clean that up. I wanted to get all the ones that I had images of in the database before I did that. But, you know, you just caption it with the descriptor.
That is fantastic. That looks wonderful.
Thank you.
That's exactly what I was hoping for. This way it'll actually encourage our faculty to start maybe thinking about the archives and what we can do to preserve their accomplishments, their records, their history, and what they can do to help us complete that historical picture for us in the archives going forward.
And what I was initially planning to do as this in-service was to make the intranet that you've created use the design principles that people have come up with throughout the years to encourage interaction on a website. And I actually have some of those that I'll share with you.
All
and that was because that was going to be this project, and there's no reason not to do it anyway.
Sounds good.
So that's what we'll do. Lisa, did you have questions?
No, I like it. It looks good. It'll be good for the archives to be able to have people be able to get to them.
Okay, good. I know, I thought this was a really good idea for something to do. It I think, needed to be done. Don't most colleges have a timeline?
Yes.
Stuff like that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Anyway, so.
And I mean, just looking at it, I'm just going to amuse people because I'm looking at it going, radio and television servicing. So, you know, when it will encourage people to get on it just to look for.
Just to see what are those fun things.
Exactly.
I
when they're looking at the fun things, they'll be like, hey, I didn't know that we had such and such when.
Yes. I didn't think nursing was the first one, but nursing was actually one of the
first
ones.
Nursing was, yeah.
Yeah. The only thing I'm sad about, because it's not the free one, we can't do the headings.
Yeah.
I wanted those for the dates.
Yeah, that one.
Oh, so much better, right? That's okay. Anyway, thank you guys. I really appreciate you taking that time to do this. I know you're busy and I will let you go.
Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Coming along very well. I definitely like it. And on the LibGuide itself, it comes up nice and clean. You can click on enhance.
Oh, you've been on the LibGuide. It does,
it
did work.
It comes up great.
Awesome. That is what I like to hear.
All right.
Okay. Thank you again. And sorry about my breakdown.
Program.